Today we are going to talk about referencing in Maya. So first question came, what is referencing? So referencing is something, rather than importing an object in Maya, you reference it. So there are certain things you get benefit from referencing. So let's start with referencing something. So how you reference? Reference editor, create reference. The shortcut is create reference. Go and click to create reference. I just have copied the path. I'll go to my project. Maya scenes, flying fox. So this is a rig. I'm referencing the rig here. So what's the difference in referencing and normal importing? First, like for example, I will open the file. Okay, on the left side of my screen, I have referenced a file. On the right side of my screen, my file is open. How to see that? If you see here, untitled, Maya 2020. And if you see here, you can see the file name. So this is the original file open. By the name, you can see that D drive, SRJ tutorial, bouncing ball, and so. So this file, if I make any changes to the file, I'm making changes to the direct raw file. The file I have there, okay, but what if I'm making changes there? I'm not making the changes in the rig file. So there is a difference. You can see there is a blue dot added to your name of the assets, and there is another model. So this is your referenced file and this is your not referenced file. If I save this file and let's name it test. Okay, it won't save as. I have to do it my boundary test. Okay, the file is saved. So if I open the raw file, so say if I have to do some animation, let's do some quick animation. This is my animation. I'll press key here and there it goes. As I'll do, sorry for this bad animation, and I'll press key. Okay, so this is the animation I did. I saved the file test. Now I have animated my file. I've done a lot of changes to my file. I want to keep it. I want to do something more animations. So what I will do, I'll make it new file. I'll create reference and there it is. Boom, back to normal. So what it does, it keep your file as it is and you created a reference to that file. So the original files remain as it was and all the changes and all the motion animation I did, it was saved. All the translate value, all the information of that movement and keys, anything I did change on top of this got saved. But the original file and the model rig, whatever is there, it stays like that. It never changes. So this is the best part of the reference. When you create a reference, you can't destroy your rig. You can't mess with it. See, if I try to delete it, it just won't happen. You can't delete it. But here, if you are imported the file, you can delete it. See, something happened. So we can see we are messing with it. So I'll show you another thing. Like if I animate here and when I open the file, I've done my animation. I just overwrite on the rig file and I have to do some more animation. What will I do? Let's say I'll just open it again. Don't see. So now we got a problem, but we just overwrite the animation on the rig file. Now the rig file has become an animation file. So now there is no rig file, because we are working on the rig directly. So when we are animating, we don't animate the rig files directly, we use referencing method. Okay guys, that's it for today. We'll join again.